The concentration of hydrogen ion in the extracellular fluid is kept constant at 40 nanomoles per liter. Our bodies produce two types of acid, volatile acid and non-volatile acid. Volatile acid forms when carbon dioxide produced by cellular respiration combines with water and forms carbonic acid. Pulmonary alveolar ventilation eliminates carbon dioxide from our body and prevents the accumulation of roughly 15,000 millimoles of carbonic acid produced daily. Respiratory acidosis develops when alveolar ventilation is impaired and can be caused by disorders of the lung or a failure of ventilation from depression of the central respiratory center or neuromuscular disease. In acute respiratory acidosis, an abrupt failure of ventilation causes the PCO2 to be elevated with an accompanying acidemia. In chronic respiratory acidosis, the PCO2 is elevated with a near normal pH, secondary to renal compensation and elevated serum bicarbonate levels. Acute respiratory alkalosis results from an acute increase in ventilation, secondary to disorders of the lung, or due to direct stimulation of the respiratory center. Chronic respiratory alkalosis allows for renal compensation and decreased bicarb levels. Metabolism of proteins generates non-volatile acids, which are buffered by both intracellular and extracellular buffers, including bicarbonate. The bicarbonate used up in the daily buffering of non-volatile acid is regenerated by the kidney. Metabolic acidosis associated with an increased anion gap may be caused by the accumulation of endogenous acids, such as lactic acid and ketones, the metabolism of exogenous ingestions, including methanol and ethylene glycol, or the inability of the kidney to regenerate bicarb because of renal failure. Loss of bicarbonate in diarrhea, or loss of bicarbonate by the kidney seen with renal tubular acidosis, causes a non-anion hyperchloremic metabolic acidosis. Metabolic acidosis stimulates ventilation with an associated decrease in the PCO2 and improvement in serum pH. Metabolic alkalosis is caused by the loss of hydrogen ion in gastric fluid, which occurs with vomiting, or the loss of hydrogen ion from the kidney, seen with either primary hyperaldosteronism or secondary hyperaldosteronism associated with diuretic use.